Better get moving before the day passes you by. Check out that silo. Might be empty, but maybe not all empty. There's some rubber scrap for you. Urfidurf outpost. The Jagni tribe claimed this forever. There's the tyrant who runs this outpost. He didn't expect his tribe to lose, as they're the ones that are ruthless. But now that you're working with their rival, he can see why. He's realized chance seems to take the side of the sharp-witted. It's their last line of defense. Once their guardian falls, they'll surrender. Outpost belongs to your tribe now. He says you made them weaker, but they won't give up. Your Sifu thanks you. Your tribe is growing stronger. Thinks you did a great job capturing the rival's third outpost and believes the rival is weak enough to engage them at their fort. Says it'll be a relief to finally have it over. Nothing like a walk in the woods. There's news of a Ronin joining the tribe. That must be you. Are you ready for the night yet? Hey, nice shot. The The dark can make you miss the day fierce. A shopperia. Maybe there's something still inside. That there's Subnautica Station. Goop flounders around in there. Make the most of the night while you can. That's a myriad tribe outpost. Watch for new trails. As long as you're happy about it. It's been a long night, but it's over soon. It's Peekaboo Park. Young ones love this sort of place. This corner of the world is called Bricktown. You made it to the quarrel spot. You've got to hate what the fighting's done to it. That's the Jagni tribe's fort. Their friendship can be a blessing or a curse. It's up to you. You're either a part of their solution to the tribe war or part of the problem. So many creatures doing so many things during the day.
I'm
They've been waiting for you. Taking control of this fort will bring peace between your tribes. You better be. A tribe's fort is a bigger challenge than an outpost. They've positioned a storm tower near the fort that you'll use to get over the wall. However, you need to prop up its wheelhouse first to stabilize the situation. Says you don't have to knock to get inside. It's time to set the whole tribe free. Inflict as little damage as possible as you make your way through to their Sifu. Convincing the Sifu that peace between your tribes is the only way you'll all survive won't be easy. He doubts the Sifu will give up without a fight. That's a fire starter. The dry grass looks like it would ignite easily. You just need to create a spark to light a fire. It burns brighter than the light. on target. So much water. That's a pyro sizzler right there. Just get to work on it. Make it frizzle. Battering Bonker looks like a great way to get through the gate. Bet you just need to knock and it'll open up. That's bonkers. The Jagni tribe wants to become omnipresent and, most importantly, feared. They want to vanquish the tribes as the only way they can guarantee peace is through supremacy. He didn't expect it would go down this way. It'll be hard to talk your way out of a fight. He knows what he needs to do, and knowing what must be done eliminates fear. rival Sifu is defeated, and the destiny of their tribe is in your hands. You are free to choose their fate, but not free from the consequences of your choice. He'll leave it up to you to decide the fate of the rival Sifu, but suggests you be merciful. Do good, and good will follow you. Thinks it's a good gesture to offer support to others when you can see that they need it. And with that, you're spinning your own fate, good or bad, never to be undone. Side by side they'll stand until order and stability is reinstituted. He wants you to focus. These are the new rival outposts your tribe needs to take control of. He says you'll regret not being on their side. The only way you'll learn their secrets, Wong Fu and the tribe weapon now, is if you defeat him. And that will never happen.
Hello?
Your Sifu is pleased. You're one step closer to uniting the tribes. It's a pity you needed to use force to get the point across.
Can't both.
But he's still concerned about the fate of the world. Believes the war you wage is based on the principle that if you win, the end will justify the means. He says you've grown so much stronger than when you first met. You know better than anyone that the fate of the world is still at stake. You need a world where everyone is guided only by their conscience. That little voice inside that lets you know right from wrong, don't go against it. If you want to enjoy life without fear of death.